Daily check-in commands are a great way to incentivize returning viewers to your stream, as well as reward your community that tunes in every time you hit go live. And better yet, whether you're streaming on Twitch or YouTube, I'm going to show you how to make it completely automated with MixItUp. So before we jump straight into it, why not, you know, like this video, subscribe, do the bell thing, all that kind of stuff, because you are an absolute legend. So as always, step number one is open up your MixItUp. And from here, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a currency. So from the big old hamburger menu, we're going to go to currency, rank, and inventory. You're going to see that I already have one created called gold stars, but just for this video, we're just going to quickly add another currency so I can show you how that flow works. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to click add currency rank, open up this nice window, and we're going to give our currency a name. So just for the purposes of this video, I'm just going to call it, if I can see my keyboard, just check-in. But for this, I would definitely recommend giving the currency or the daily check-in currency a name that kind of ties to the brand of your stream. For me, I wanted to do gold stars because it kind of reminded me, like, you know, when you're in primary schools and teacher would just give you like those little gold star stickers. That's the vibe I wanted to go towards. But I know that streamers like Mama Tamago, she has hers branded as like, you know, eggs and omelette, because that again fits within her whole brand. Now, it's probably a bit of bias from the designer inside of me saying that's got to be tied to a brand. It's not a must have. I'll just kind of recommend doing it. Just, you know, make your stream that bit more customized and personalized to your overall brand and theming. So now that we're giving this currency a name, we're just going to leave all these top values as default. But with the online rate, we're going to change it from 1 per minute to disabled. Now, if we left it at 1 per minute, MixItUp would essentially automatically reward a user 1 unit of this currency for every minute they're watching a stream, which again is not what we want. We want to manually assign and manually give users 1 of this currency every time they check in. These role bonuses and event bonuses, this we're just going to leave as off. And then for the settings, if you wanted to, you could set this automatic reset to, let's say, yearly or monthly if you kind of wanted to reset those check-in values. But for me, I want this to kind of be like an all-time value, so I'm just going to leave that reset to never. Now we're going to hit the save button. It's going to ask us if it wants us to create some automatic commands for this currency. Now, I'd recommend just making all of these commands and then turning it off. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to hit yes. It will manually create those 4 commands within our chat command. So if we go back to the burger menu, we go to commands, it would have made all these commands within this ungrouped category. Now to go from the top to the bottom of these commands, the first one, add all check-in, this can only be done by a moderator. This allows a mod to add every user in the stream 1 of that currency. So let's say if the automation went wrong and you kind of noticed part of the way through, your mod could then trigger this command and then manually assign everyone 1 extra of that currency. So I'll just recommend leaving that on just in case something goes wrong. Add check-in is the same kind of automation except it's specified for a user. Again, I'd recommend leaving that on. This third one, give check-in, this I'd recommend turning off. So this essentially lets users kind of trade the currency. So I could give someone else, let's say, 3 daily check-ins. It's kind of that trade mindset. It works for some currencies depending on how you use them. But for this automation, I don't think it's really the right context. So I'd recommend turning that one off. In this last one, user check-in, this just lets users check how many times they've checked in. So, I mean, there's no harm in that. I'd recommend just leaving that on. Now to go back within our currencies, one thing you want to do before you make the action group for, you know, assigning this daily check-in is one thing you want to note on is the special identifiers here. So you can see within our gold stars currency and our check-in currency, they both follow the same format of $user and then the currency name. You can see here, $target user, currency name. Same one here, and then also top 10. So I would recommend just jotting down that first special identifier of $user and then your currency name, as we will need that for the automation. And again, since I have this already set up, I'm just gonna delete this currency we just created, just again to make my mixing up nice and clean. And from here, we're gonna go to the menu and we're gonna go into our action groups. You can see here that I have my daily check-in trigger action group. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna edit the action group. Just going to move it into the middle and make it a bit taller so that you can see everything all at once before we run through it. So the first thing up the top is you can see that we've unlocked the command. Again, we want the command to run whenever we trigger it. We don't want it to sit within any queue, so we want to unlock it. And from here, you can see that we have these 2 actions nested within this conditional. Now, actually, before we jump into the conditions, I want to quickly note on how there are two ways in which you can trigger your daily check-ins, which is relevant for these conditionals. The first is more automated through a user's entrance command, and the second is more manual where it's through like a channel point reward or a manual chat command. So for me, since I stream on YouTube, there are no channel point rewards, so I have it set up through the user's entrance command, and that's why I have the condition at the top saying that the streams watched must be greater than one. I want to reward people that return to my stream to keep on returning. Therefore, whenever they tune in for their second stream or greater, then they get their daily check-in. So that's the first condition. And the second two are essentially to make sure that whenever I send chat messages in chat, that since I would be entering the chat, I'm not getting awarded these daily check-ins, as since I'm the streamer, I don't really need much incentive to return to the stream. So that's what those two values are there. So again, since I stream on YouTube, I've just kind of done both formats in which it could be displayed with either the space as like a display name or as a, like the ampersand tag. So you could do this if you have different variations of how your username is spelt or displayed. So that's essentially the conditional values. And then from there, let's go into the two actions. The first is essentially adding one gold star to the user that triggered it. And the next is sending a chat message saying, welcome back at $username. Appreciate you being here. So here's a gold star just for you. That means that you have a grand total of $user gold stars. Keep up the good work. So again, this is where that special identifier comes into handy. So this will display how many gold stars this user has now earned. So it's essentially everything for the action group. So we're just going to hit save. And then from here, now we want to go into the event in which we want to trigger this action group. So again, for me, since I have this set up through the entrance commands, we're just going to hit the burger menu. We're going to go down to our events, and then we're going to go into the chat category, I believe it is. Once Mix It Up loads, chat. And then you can see here, chat user entrance command. And we're just going to hit the nice pencil button. And you can see here, all I've done is I've just triggered that action group to run the daily check-in trigger. Now, one important thing to note here is that if you have set up custom user entrance commands, for example, if you're playing any welcome sound effects once they enter the chat, that this default user entrance command will not run. This is why we've set this up as an action group. So essentially within each user's custom entrance commands where you're playing that sound or triggering that sound, you can just run this one action group and make sure they're still awarded their daily check-in. Lastly, in the case if you have opted to set this up as a Twitch channel point reward, you just want to make sure that you've set up your cooldown and limits to make sure that it's limited to one per user per stream. So if I open up my Twitch dashboard over here, for the reward name, I've just made check-in. For the cost, I've set it up as one. I mean, viewers should have at least one channel point to redeem. And lastly, if we scroll down to the bottom with cooldown and limits, we've set it up to limit the redemption per user per stream as one. So you would hit create, you would create your channel point, you know, upload any icons or anything you want. And then within your Mix It Up, you would just go from the burger menu to Twitch channel point rewards, which is just here. And then you would just trigger that action group within that channel point the same way that we've done within the user entrance command event. I mean, that's pretty much everything you need to know with daily check-ins. I mean, there's so much more you could do with daily check-ins than just this automation. You could do events, you could do giveaways, you could do prizes based on how many times users have checked into your stream. So, you know, sky's the limit with that one. But as always, if you do have any questions, don't hesitate to leave those in the comments down below. You should, you know, like, comment, subscribe, ring that bell. The join button doesn't exist on the channel yet, but maybe one day we'll get there. So in the distant future, if that button is there, you should do that too, because that would be cool. The support and whatnot from 2023 Drew. But yeah, thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy. Treat people with kindness. It's been me, Drew, your friendly neighborhood Mix It Up ambassador, and I'll see you next time.